All right, I'll get out of the mumble. See everyone, thanks for watching. Watch Pure destroy KSS.
Thanks for running, guys. It's entertaining commentary, good run.
It's a pleasure.
Thanks, Ankir.
See everyone, thanks for watching. Pure destroy KSS.
Thanks for running, guys. It's entertaining commentary, good run.
It's a pleasure.
All right, real quick, we have a donation for $15.74 from one Eggman, and he says Kirby is cute, and I'm going to assume that that means we've met the new hand cam incentive, so thank you very much, Eggman. Up next, we're going to have Kirby Superstar by Hunky. Kirby Superstar is a fantastic speedrun. I believe we're doing 100% because it's the only Kirby Superstar category that I'm aware of. And if you're wondering who we are, what we're doing, why the stream's on, this is JRTA2. We're here to try and raise money to get some speedrunners to AGDQ 2016 all the way from Japan to middle of DC in cold weather. That'll be fantastic for him. We're going to get Bacord, who is playing Gimmick, who has been accepted for Gimmick in AGDQ, and he's also been waitlisted for Wario Land 3. And we have Ohan, who's down for Mega Man 6, Castlevania 3, and then is waitlisted for Mega Man 5. So we're at, let me get the right number, $933.83 out of our goal of $4,500. So we're making pretty good progress. Thank you guys all for your generous donations. And yeah, just sit back, relax, enjoy. And I think we're going to have some commentators or maybe one commentator coming in for KSS who know a whole lot about the game. So hopefully they are coming in soon and can fill dead air better than I can. I see. I will say that during this run, we have a prize. You can win a set of Kirby games for the Super Famicom. Let me pull up what this list is. And it looks like Kirby Superstar and Kirby Dream Land 3, maybe? There's a 3 in the title. I don't know Japanese, I'm sorry. But there's two Kirby games for the Famicom. And if you've got Dream Land 3, okay. If you've got a regular, you know, US SNES, you can take a pair of tweezers and like snap off the tabs on the inside of the cart slot. And you can run Famicom games all day after that. So don't be worried that, oh, I've got to buy a new console if I win this prize. It's like, no. Just like, tear out the plastic inside your SNES and it works just fine. And it's a lot less horrible sounding than what I just said. And if you would like to help out our marathon, but you are unable to donate, or, you know, just can't afford it right now, don't worry, just by watching, you know you're helping our numbers. You can tell your friends, you can tweet about the marathon. If you're not going to be streaming, you can host us this weekend. Yeah. So yeah, don't worry if you can't donate, just you're doing great just by being here watching us and enjoying the marathon.
Hello.
What's up?
How's everyone doing?
I am doing better now that you're here to talk instead of me.
Should you type it to him?
part when you see it on the screen.
Yeah. Worked hard for that one.
What number is he?
Two. You could put it over the character, I guess.
That doesn't really matter, I don't think.
Unprepared for hand cam is SGDQ.
Oh, that plush. I'm so excited for this.
Yeah, I'm excited for the 112 as well.
Where's Countdown? What the heck?
Can I read a couple of donations while guys are working stuff out?
Sure.
Alright, Ivan donated $15 and said, Hunky Handcam, which, since it's been met, we put that towards the streamer's bags of cash. So, real quick, a couple runs from now, streamers we played, and we've got two incentives for it, one of which is 16 bags of cash, which is $100, and we're at $35. And there's also a bonus run of Superb Joe after the other run, and that's at $0 out of a goal of 50. So those are a couple things you can donate to. We've also got Final Fantasy 3. During the credits, the runner Nacho will be playing Trip World. During the credits, he's going to erase it. And if you have never seen Trip World, it's a great, fantastic short game. If you've never seen Final Fantasy 3, it's also, you know, a pretty good speedrun. So that's something else you can donate to. And then there is a file name choice for Blast Corps. And right now, anime is winning. It's standing alone in its feel as it should be winning. And then we've got another donation by Jaguar King. He donated $20, and he said, "Gotta support my fellow Japanese speedrunners. Good luck, everyone, and have a nice marathon." So thank you very much, Jaguar King and Ivan, for your wonderful donations. And that's all I got.
Wait. Okay, there we go. So this is Kirby Superstar 100%. So he's going to be doing everything. And right off the bat, I need to explain. He's going to be doing what's called a mix. When you inhale two powers at once, it goes through a roulette of all the powers in the game, pretty much. And each one is a four-frame window. You can choose what you want to get, as long as you can hit it.
Of course, you got wheel, which is early, right?
Yeah, that's early. 1 to 4 frames early. And it doesn't matter how much you've played this game, this will happen.
Oh,
you did a nice backup
the
there.
Hell?
I don't know. 1 minute in, I'm already lost. That's right. But yeah, so that's how he gets Jet. That's the only way to get Jet in this part of the game. I believe there's only one in all of Dynablade, and it's the last secret area, so basically useless. As you can see, Jet just destroys everything. It's generally the fastest way of moving through this entire game. There will be switching to other powers, but Jet is the go-to.
Already mind blown. Evo mind blown by that backup.
Evo mind blown. So he destroyed Chef Kawasaki there by doing a charged jet jump into him as he spawned before he hit the ground. And it's just instant kills.
That's
all the mini bosses.
That's a relatively newer strat too. You used to grab the candy at the old strat.
Hmm. You'll see that super jump a few more times. Ooh, is he gonna do the clip?
I believe he is.
Oh, he's doing the clip. Okay, so this is an alternate strat here. Oh, he's getting some really bad luck. It'll be fine, but basically, instead of going through an auto-scroller up ahead, you grab Samir, you make a partner. Oh, this is one of the two optional switches in Dynablade required for 100%. But that's irrelevant. Anyway, he's gonna do an out-of-bounds setup here, where he needs to rely on his AI partner, which is very unfortunate, because they're not that smart. Right. Easy every time, so that just skipped a long auto-scroller, but unfortunately he has to mix again to get Jet back.
That was actually the easy part. This is the...
Yeah, the clip is easy. It's free. This is annoying. Ooh, yeah, got it early. Let's see the backup this time.
Oh, he went way back out of the way.
Yeah, unfortunately there's not really a great backup for this.
Yeah, he would have reset like a million times by now, but in a real run, but this is a marathon run, so...
Mm-hmm. I'm glad he showed it off, though.
Yeah.
Way more courage than I have.
Yeah.
There we go.
I don't think anyone in the marathon has done that.
No, not at all. But that's alright. Overall, that clip probably saves less than you think. It's like 8 seconds, optimally. But luckily, it's really early in the run.
The auto-scroller is pretty long, but the setup for the clip in the mix just take a long time, so it doesn't...
It's drumming away. Hey, luckily, in 100%, you have a choice of what game you want to start with, and so Dynablade has two really hard mixes in the first 2 to 3 minutes. You can choose to do this first. Now you can see the power of Jet moving through all these rooms. It's got a ton of different ways to move, depending on if you dash first, if you hold Y for a certain amount of frames. And when you saw him throw the guy back there, it's because he was accidentally holding a direction on the D-pad. That's a common error. Really hard to prevent. Gotta love Coco Cave music.
It has one of my favorite soundtracks.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Every game, every song in this game is...
Okay, he already did this once, but I missed explaining it. When he's going off the screen like that with a super jump, he's skipping a mini-boss. And so there was a Bugsy there, but because he was off-screen, it never spawned. It's also done quite a lot. No hot dogs in the waterfall.
Not much to say about these.
Nah. Dynablade 4 is pretty much just a test of your Jet skills.
Does that mean I've got time for a quick donation?
Sure. Go ahead.
Nox donated $10 and said put this towards Trip World. Thanks. And thank you, Nox.
You're welcome. Just for the record, our friend ZZZ Honky here he's just incredible at Dynablade in general. Like, overall, it may not look like it, but his movement is so much tighter than everyone else in this part of the game. It's really insane times.
Yeah, like his average time is time that I can't even get, like, for my best, like, ever.
Yeah, his average time is usually better than my best segment. Oh, this is a very long string of mini-bosses he's going to skip.
either time the jets, or you can just mash like he did.
Yeah. You need about 13 or 14 jets to get over all of them successfully. If you mess it up, you can land in a few safe spots, but it's kind of up to luck. It's best to just go over it in one. Alright, so he's going to fight Dynablade now, and... So earlier you saw a mini throw on an enemy with the jet, but if you charge up first, you do a crazy supercharged jet suplex. And when Dynablade lands on the ground, two stars come out of, I guess, thin air, and they count as projectiles, so he can grab it and do massive damage. Just like that. And luckily Dynablade did not dodge. Pretty sick kill.
You can actually one-shot if you get super lucky. Yeah. When the star hits him, but that's really rare.
Look at the lamp. Yeah, the one shot is extremely rare. See, okay, he's doing cave second. This is the longest part of the game. You gotta get all the treasures for 100%, which is good because it requires you to do way more gameplay. There's 60 treasures, right? I think so. Yep, you're gonna see a big variety of stuff throughout here. It's also probably the hardest part of the game.
I would agree with that.
Mm-hmm.
Especially the tower, just...
Oh, the tower.
So much can go wrong.
Nobody likes the tower. Unfortunately, he'll be there soon. So the whole game you've seen Jet up till now, but right here he's gonna grab Wing. Which is also a really cool movement power. Yep, you can use the Wing Smash to send out two projectiles to hit both those switches. It's also, in a few rooms, you'll see Wing Smash canceling, which you probably want to watch his hand cam for, because it's a mash fest. And it's really funky movement. See, already, movement in this game is so different from the first 7 or so minutes. It's one of the great things about this run. This is really tight, all of it. So this should be a Wing Smash up here. Yeah. Oh, that was beautiful.
Gentry.
He beat the music loop, that's super good.
Cave 1 is incredible so far.
Mm-hmm. This is my least favorite part of Cave, actually. Forget the tower. A little bad luck on these poppy rows. Lots and lots of enemies in your way. Have random factors to them in this game. There goes Bonkers. Got by the Plasma Wisp. These are all really tight corridors in Cave 1, and yet Wing allows you to do some really cool movements through them.
Fortunate, you didn't get in the hole, that was kind of weird.
Yeah. One tile gaps in this game are very terrible. They are impossible to get into. In fact, in some cases, there are even setups to get into one tile gaps.
For a while, that no one like had a good way to do that room.
Mm-hmm.
I forgot. I think it was Aranis, yeah. And we were like, what the heck?
X runner of this game. We think X, since he just disappeared in general, he might still be playing.
Gonna resurface him. Okay. 111.
Post is 111 on VC. Okay, switching back to Jet for Fatty Whale here. He can give two patterns. And he gave the bad one. There's nothing you can do about this, just instant time loss compared to the other one. It's also harder to execute. But he did the kill for that pattern perfectly. But you'll be seeing Fatty Whale again later. So it's faster to skip the minecart here with Jet. It's kind of tricky. A few options.
There was no like setup or strat for it. It was hard, but...
Mm-hmm. But that went fine. Cave 2's kind of slow, I guess. It's probably the easiest part of a cave.
I'm not relaxing to doing a run, I feel like.
Yeah.
Not really anything really too execution heavy, but...
It's a lot of swimming.
Yeah.
But there's still some cool stuff. Yo, that pineapple killed himself. Water physics are super weird. If you don't grab that chest, it just falls down the hole and you have to reset the room to grab it again. There's a few chests you can screw yourself out of. Not completely permanently, but you always have to reset the room. I think he's gonna go for a cool looking super jump kill on the next mini boss. Ooh. See, that's the tricky part of that, is to do some of these super quick, you have to start the charge, and then jump, and then start charging again. And it's a really tricky series of inputs, and got a little messed up there, so he had to do a slightly slower kill.
He recovered pretty.
Yeah, good recovery. Poppy Bros has the least health of all mini bosses, I think.
Like 2 charge jets.
Mm-hmm. Yes, by far the least. There are some mini bosses where it's quite punishing to kill them with Jet normally. So if you did the first part of this room fast enough, these platforms will be at the right place, which they are, to where you can just sneak by them. Pretty good, that's what you want.
Actually, I had no idea this would run a global timer.
Yeah, I believe it's just this room, like, as you enter. There's another chest you can miss, and then you gotta redo the entire room. Everyone's super careful on that one.
I've ever missed it in a run, but...
No, me either. I still fear it, though. Captain Falcon's helmet. This is my favorite room in Cave 2. It's really nice. That just skips by everything. Oh, and as you can see there, after a charge jet, you have a little bit of invincibility when you land. As you can see, he stood in some spikes for a bit. That's really helpful.
I think when you initially charge the jet,
Okay, this is the first of 3 Battle Windows fights. It's probably the most random boss in the game. And Slime was nice, but each of these guys can either attack, defend, or you can go first. For all these, obviously you want to go first so they don't just waste your time. That was optimal luck on that. You actually wanted the witch to guard at the end, because if it's a killing blow, your attack will do its maximum damage. That was really lucky. Unfortunately, the other 2 Battle Windows fights are more punishing with luck. Really good cave, too.
They're, hard skip.
Yeah, this is a much harder one. Okay, so Old Tower, this thing has gone through a ton of route revisions over the last year and a half. I feel like it gets harder each time. But basically, you can skip this tower completely if you don't want any treasures, but if you do want treasures, it's a big labyrinth. And there's going to be multiple death abuses and power switching and all kinds of stuff.
Basket.
Yep. There's just some... There's even dialogue with those mini-bosses, I think. Really cool way to kill bonkers. After this next chest, he's gonna kill himself, and it's gonna take him back to the start of the tower, where he's going to have to mix for Jet again. Luckily, it's the same mix timing as the very first one in Dynablade, so everyone's really used to the timing. Very consistent at wheel.
Okay.
Yeah, that's unfortunate.
Yeah, remember these are all 4 frames. And while that sounds fairly big compared to certain speedruns, there's really no visual cue for it at all because it's blinking way too fast. It's gonna go for the Mr. Saturn treasure. All these statues put you to sleep if you touch them, which means you lose your power and you waste a bunch of time. It's way less punishing in this route than an old one to actually go to sleep, but you're not gonna see it either way. Terrifying room in marathon runs, believe me.
Especially if blue glass. Yeah.
Mr. Saturn! This is like the only room in the game with gravity like this, and it doesn't really make sense. But unfortunately with the gravity, you also have to get in that one tile gap, which, as you know, is really difficult, which is why he did that little hover, and it somehow sets you up to get in the gap most of the time.
Then it's like impossible to get back up there. You have to wait for the gravity.
It's really bad, yeah. And then you guess wrong on when the gravity reset, and you're just bouncing on the spring over and over. This is another major route deviation. He's gonna grab Wing and fight Camellia now. He's gonna Wing Smash over and over. It's the same as the Wing Smash canceling, except much slower, because he's allowing himself to hit the ground. That was an extremely good fight. Wow.
Got the bad pattern.
Yeah.
Bottom pass.
You can just get... Good.
You can just sit in the corner and it's really easy to kill him, but...
Oh yeah.
Went to the middle.
Camellia opens with 2 different things. But that was really impressive though. Anyway, now he's gonna use Wing to grab the stuff in this part of the tower, and he's gonna die again. And the Camellia room is the checkpoint, so he'll respawn back there. Very convenient.
An okay time to say stuff?
1 second.
Alright.
So let me explain this real quick. So now he's gonna grab Plasma, which is an amazing power. Gets stronger the more you mash the D-pad, but that's not important right now. The only way to get through this next section is to... Well, you have to destroy this block, and luckily Plasma can shoot through walls like that. An upcoming... But basically, there's only a few powers you can use to get the treasures in this area, and to get them all in one go, there's even less options, but luckily Plasma will allow him to get everything coming up. You can read something now.
Just gonna remind people that if they want to donate $10 or more during this run, they're into a chance to win Kirby Superstar and Kirby's Dream Land 3 for the Super Nintendo. And if you can't donate, you know, you can just help us out by giving us a host on your Twitch channel if you're not gonna be streaming this weekend.
Those are the lower charges of Plasma. Okay, so this room is a giant pain. He needs to get through here, grab the treasure, and grab a Samira partner. And also grab Stone for himself. That was way better than it can go. Smear is a very fragile partner, but you need to keep him around for a while. As he gets completely destroyed. Luckily, that was a low damage roll by that enemy.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Nah, he should be fine. There's health here, but...
Yeah, there's a pretty much forced health refill right here. Quick little makeout sesh. Basically, he's carrying this mirror with him so he can have two powers at once, essentially. Wow, that was a clutch block by Samir at the end. Because he needs stone to get through this section. Well, he doesn't. He could use mirror, but still, it's faster to use stone. Because he's going to do that perfect elevator clip.
Yep, skips the entire elevator. You still have to wait for this one to go up. But...
That was so fast, he had to wait for this one to come up. And unfortunately, this one's harder, but that was still fast enough to save time. These clips are pretty much the whole reason this route saves time, it turns out, which is pretty annoying because they're hard. But luckily, now he has mirror, which is going to let him do another really tough trick in the next room. After he gets by this suplex. Okay. Whoop. It wasn't the terrible pattern where he can grab you and make you lose your power instantly. This is skipping the pool with a one-frame trick. Yeah, this is a huge pain. You gotta make your mirror go up and down by dashing, jumping, and then stopping your momentum. But he got it really, really quick.
That could take forever.
Yeah, people get stuck in infinites.
Yeah, the timing is really weird on that. It feels inconsistent sometimes, but... Uh-oh.
Oh, God! I'm freaking out right now.
Oh, there we go.
Oh my God.
That room is scary as hell.
Oof, okay, then a purposeful death. He's freaking out in the hand cannon. Yeah.
But you watch the stream, he acts like his run is dead. It's pretty funny.
Yeah. That was terrifying.
Funny sounds.
Oh my gosh.
But yeah.
If he died early there, he would have had to retrace his steps.
Oh yeah, that would have taken forever. He would have to kill the mini-boss again. Oh, I don't even know where he would spawn him. I think it would spawn him, in the middle tower.
I think it spawns you back at, the beginning area, where you can choose where to enter.
Oh, yeah.
That's an interesting petting zoo entrance.
Get hit by every enemy.
you have to see all the animals. The Cave 4 is... I don't know if I'd call it hard overall, but there are some do-or-die tricks in it, to say the least, if you're going for a really good time. Which, of course, he's going to go for.
Anki always goes all out, pretty much, for his strats.
Oh, yeah. There are no safe strats.
Actually, there's a lot, but he doesn't do them.
There are no safe strats.
There's a trick that can cost a lot of time if he messes up coming up.
Yeah, after he comes back here, he's going to go for a quick cannon entrance. Is really cool if he gets it. One tile gap again. Right here is going to charge Jet and then set off the plunger with the back burner. Run over here and try to do a quick super jump to break the bomb block. Unfortunately, he was just a pixel too far to the right or something.
But you get the idea.
Yeah.
What he was trying to do.
I think the game robbed him, to be honest, but... This is a really confusing area, where you can't exactly see where you can go. I believe the stars mark all the places you can go. But it's tough to get good movement through it. Great setup to leave that room.
Yeah, it's really subtle, the clues they give you.
Yeah, I didn't know about the stars until, I think someone told me at SGDQ. But there's a quick little partner jump off a Jet. So normally you can jump off most of your partners, I think, by just holding up and landing on them. But by transforming like that midair, he's able to break the block with an instant jump. This room, we're gonna meet our best pal, Wheelie. Really fast, and he's gonna be used a lot through the rest of the game. He's fine in that regard until you have to rely on his AI to do stuff for you. Just not at the moment. Right now, Wheelie's just cool all the way around. So appreciate him while you can. Really awkward movement. And also, fortunately, you can grab chests on Wheelie by sliding. You can buffer chest grabs, just hold up as you go over them. It's really nice. Allows you to do a few cool things. Scientist on Mumble. He's here with me.
Not a real runner.
Not a real runner.
Not really a runner, whatever. I forgot what he said.
Oh, man.
That was funny.
Oh, there's the cannon mistake. These are tricky.
God.
Oh, man. I believe they always reset to their original position when you enter them. Thankfully. So similar to the jet super jump, you can do a partner super jump like that and instant kill a mini boss. And that's part of why Wheelie is a bad guy later on, because right there it never seems to happen, but Wheelie can move around if he wants to and make you miss. I've never seen it on that mini boss though, so it really doesn't make sense to me. Clutch teleport from Wheelie. Gotta grab Crash to hit this switch through the wall, and I'm pretty sure this is intended. I know it looks really goofy.
I see. I don't know how else you can get it.
And they put it right there. Let's do this massive explosion screen, then tink.
I think two player, maybe you could do something, I don't know.
Oh, yeah. Good thinking. Well, this is the do or die trick coming up. It's called Cutter Skip. And basically, he's gonna skip a bunch of this room by trying to get under a falling platform before it blocks off a treasure. He did it.
Every time.
That method really scares me, but he makes it work. Yeah, once that platform hits the ground, it's blocked, and you would have to reset the room to get that treasure. Coming down here to grab the Triforce, that's all the treasures. What's left is to kill Wham Bam Rock and escape. Wham Bam is a really cool fight. So in addition to Wheelie being really fast, he's also super strong. As you will hopefully see. Yep, you start revving up in the hitbox. His health just falls.
Wait.
Yep. That one's a little scary. You go for the aerial first hit, because if you do it too late, the hand will knock you off, and it's a huge pain. But he's a god. It's alright. Oh, that was funky. Yeah, pretty good cave.
Uh-oh.
Oh. Okay. See, he'll probably do Meta Knight next. Yeah, this is a really hard part of the game as well. It's gonna immediately start with another jet mix. Fortunately, it's the easiest one in the game because it's only two ticks into the roulette. You can still miss it, obviously, but it's just much easier because it's not in the middle of no man's land. The setup is the hardest in the game, though.
I still don't know the best way to do that.
Oof. There we go. Yeah, that setup is crazy. You can see the yo-yo guy decided to attack, so he had to play it a little safe. This is basically... I guess the featured thing of Meta Knight as a game is auto-scrollers. Quite a few of them. This is essentially an auto-scroller. Where'd he go?
What the hell? Magic.
Magic. Put the controller down. Stay off screen. Crash mix strat.
Yeah, you can actually get crash with a mix and...
Going fast, yeah.
Definitely, yeah.
I think it's slower, though.
Yeah, it is.
Here we are in Grape Garden. Kirby's gotta fight his way back to the Halberd. That's a really cool bonk strat to get in a fight to skip the mini-boss that was discovered by Tessiro, who's in the chat. Full credit to him. Yeah, man. You discover something, you get a shout-out. Just wait till Euphoria, buddy.
Epic Euphoria.
There's some cool movement through the water, and now another auto-scroll. The scary thing about this auto-scroll, oh god, is that if you hit something and your power comes out, it's gone. Nothing you can do. And you cannot get jet back for a while. There's also potential for some swag here.
Yeah.
I don't know if he's feeling it. Looks like he's feeling it.
God.
Oh, he's feeling it.
I actually don't even know how to do that.
I gotta take my pod champ out. Hold on.
Apparently it's easy.
Apparently it's easy, except you do run the risk of getting hit. You can stay out of bounds all the way to the end of this auto-scroller. Unfortunately, it saves zero time, but it makes you cool. Okay, gonna fight Twin Woods here. Well, single Wispy Woods and then Twin Woods. Just rhythmically kick him. And that's the strategy. Oh, he got appled. Uh-oh. Okay. So that's the one apple spawn that can hit you, and he went for the kill. These are really cool screens. You just get to show off how good you are at Jet. Especially through this tree. Now the next room, though, has, I think, probably the hardest little mini-boss thing in the game, and also random. There's two bonkers. So he's gonna try to super jump kill this first one. Let's see what he does for the second. Okay, so he got bad luck from the bonkers. He kinda just stood there. That was a sick kill, though.
He just straight up tried to go for the kill.
Yeah, I've never actually seen that. Yeah, Bonkers just stood there and stared him down. Really, you want him to do a pattern where he jumps three times and you can super jump kill him too. But that looked just as fast to me.
Yeah. That might just be better. Just...
Ooh.
Waiting just waste so much time.
Mm-hmm. You feel like an idiot when staring him down.
He doesn't jump.
Yeah, when I play and he gives that pattern, I'm staring at him like a fool.
And then you try to do the, like, the...
Do the, like, one pixel super jump kill.
Never kills. Yeah.
So garbage. Dynablade's your friend now. Takes you back to the Halberd. Pick up the lag on this screen. Ooh.
Pretty sure she does.
Never seen again.
Yeah, most people just super jump to the top, fly over everything, but he does like hard strat.
I'm not even sure which is faster, but
yeah.
They're both laggy.
Fly around the sand.
Another cool set of runes. Another important double mini boss.
Risky strat.
Oh, risky strat. That was perfectly executed. I think you can see what happened. Just throw one in the other. Next up is Twin Cannon, Combo Cannon, whatever he's called. So you want to hit him with his charge jet, which sets up the bomb, which you throw, and you kick him. Dies.
Really sick Meta Knight so far.
Really is, yeah. Honky grinded out ILs for pretty much every game in this game, so he knows what he's doing.
I don't think he's actually done like serious runs in a while, but
doesn't matter. Kirby's in his blood.
Like Oxus, Oxus can get 115 time whenever he feels like it.
Mm-hmm. Nice block. This is a really annoying section of rooms. You got to use the balls that come out of a fully charged jet to hit below the floor. This is a mini boss skip right in the ceiling here. It's the only one you can skip that way. Skip the Mr. Frosty guy. Shakes his butt at you.
Frame, IO jump.
IO jump. So hard. Really sick way to get through these rooms. Now, another heavy lobster auto scroll into the boss fight. You finally get to beat him up. Let's see if he does the swag in this auto scroll. I think he does it every time, so. It's also not nearly as risky as the other one.
Yeah, this is what he does now. He guards here.
Yeah.
It's actually pretty safe.
Yeah.
Do a thing where like he would like go super close to it because the hitbox of the heavy lobster is pretty small actually. Like go underneath it and like run away. I don't think he does that anymore.
Now you gotta fight heavy lobster. It's really annoying because he's random. He's getting V pattern right now though. Oh yeah, easy every time.
That was disgusting.
It's disgusting. Yep. Oh, it's important to remember the. It's called Jet Cracker, but I just call them the blue balls that come out of the jet. They do more damage than if you were to fully charge your jet and ram into the thing. So in situations like that, it's important to hit Y to stop it again and use the blue balls before Kirby actually makes contact, because that'll do less damage. Right here, he's going to tag out Jet for Plasma, because Plasma speeds up the upcoming bosses way too much. And that's your last chance to get it. They don't actually want you having Plasma for Meta Knight, but you gotta carry it. Fortunately, if you use a fully charged Plasma shot, it shoots out two back sparks at an angle, which let them hit the switch through the wall there. I guess I can explain Plasma in general now. You mash the D-pad, and it gets stronger with every input, and I think it's 16 plus you get the big ball.
Yeah, that's right.
Alright, so when he's shooting Plasma at any point, when you see the big ball, he is a mashing machine. The actor is a terrible boss. You can see him mashing away there. Oh yeah, kill the floor things. But you gotta trick the lasers into hitting the core.
It's really, and... really, really annoying.
Oh yeah, it's terrible. Sometimes it comes up in places where you think it would hit, but just illogically misses. Anyway, that was a beautiful fight. The other thing, other way to speed it up is, as soon as the laser shoots, you want to kill it, because it'll start the next attack. But you don't want to do it too soon to where it doesn't shoot a laser.
Your Oxus, you can speed it up even more and like kill like the reactor
yeah,
itself
kill the reactor.
By mashing super fast, but I think only he can do that.
It's ridiculous. Yeah, you saw him kill the things in the floor also. It takes two big ball shots for those. Yeah, and your plasma charge goes down by one every 52 frames, as Ox said. I love commentating KSS, because even when Ox is running, he just corrects me in the chat. Frame counts. The last JRTA, I believe it was Ox was running this, who had a great run. And we got kind of the successor to him. ZZZ Honky is the king of KSS. This is a really cool mini boss fight. There's 9 dudes that spawn, 3 at a time. But due to the back sparks, you can kind of stay in the air and kill them like that. Oh, missed the guy a little. That's okay.
I don't think he actually lost any time.
No. You can hit EZQ. This is Meta Knight. Really random fight. You do this weird partner stuff to grab the sword and trigger him sooner. But re-grab plasma, because it's way better. Basically, you want to just assault him and pray he doesn't go invincible, like he just did. Oops. Oh my gosh.
Super Smash Brothers Brawl right now.
He's going Brawl, man. You can see Meta Knight did all that with, like, no HP. That tornado attack is garbage, and a lot of times, unless you read it ahead of time and hop over him, it'll hit you no matter what.
That was unfortunate luck.
Mm-hmm. But that's Meta Knight. I believe, unless you're just stupidly fast, I believe he can always get one attack in. That's what it seems like anyway. This is the escape. Pretty easy.
One mechanic about the skill is that if you jump, you gain little... I think you gain pixels. I think it's slightly faster.
Mm-hmm. But it's like arm pumping. Something. But Meta Knight's way more likely to hit you in that escape if you're jumping. Save a few frames.
If you're holding a jump.
Oh, that makes sense. Yeah, I guess that does make sense.
You like tap it and like let go, like you get hit. I don't know, it's really weird.
Mm-hmm. Alright, well that was a really great Meta Knight. Revenge of Meta Knight. So now he's on to Gourmet Race, which has totally different physics than the rest of the game. As you can see, Kirby's running super fast. This is only like a 3-minute section of the game. So what he went for there was, in this section alone, if you let go of the D-pad as you're running, and then jump immediately after, you'll conserve your running speed in the air. Pretty tricky to do optimally. Shoutouts to Ohan and Gourmet too.
You don't know, Ohan has the best time ever in this in this aisle.
He must have played it for 10k hours or something, because his time is ridiculous. But yeah, Gourmet 2 is super hard. So is 3.
I think his time is like a 30.99 or something like that. 30.99.
Yeah, it's 30.99.
That's really fast.
33.99. Oh, his speed is straight up doubled in Gourmet according to Ox. In this one, you want to grab Wing. I'm going to do a few crazy... Yeah, there's the Wing smashes.
I don't go for it there, because...
That's a scary one.
If you hit the spike, you can lose your power.
Mm.
If the power hits the spike, you just lose it.
Yeah, the star will just disappear.
Yeah, it'll crumble.
This is so hard to control, Gourmet 3, because not only are you double speed, but you're using Wing. Navigate through here, do one final really tough Wing smash to get up this last part. That was amazing. That's it for Gourmet Race. If you do the 3 hard games, just do Gourmet, Spring Breeze, get them done. Short games. Spring Breeze, pretty basic. Lots of... I don't know about lots, but most of the time difference in this comes from randomness. You need to see Beam. It's the best option, because Spring Breeze is what you're supposed to play first. What they expect you to play first, rather. Some cool moves on Poppy here. Nice luck. Poppy can charge you, and it's a huge disaster. Ooh, I love that strat. You get to fight solo Wispy Wood. And just charge beam him 5 times. Really simple. So in Gourmet Spring Breeze 2 here, he wants to actually lose his power. It's the only time you want to lose your power. And it's totally random in this game, except for a few attacks. And no luck, so he's gonna have to get rid of Beam manually soon. Just a minor time loss. Not a huge deal. I guess this is the first Super Candy in the game now. Just makes you invincible. Decimates everything you run into.
Why didn't, like, Dino 3 or something?
Oh yeah, Dino 4, that's right. I don't even know this game. Yep, grab Crash, instant kill, blah blah blah, and blah blah blah. And then he's gonna go for a setup to despawn his partner during the transition. Just like that. So that skips the animation of the game freezing for a few seconds as the partner despawns. Really minimizes the time loss from not getting your power knocked out.
Start mashing. Goes all out.
Oh, here we go. The random enemies of Spring Breeze 3. This room right here is the worst. You're just at their mercy. Yeah, as Ox points out, the first time you say play Spring Breeze on a file, the HP is lower than if you were to replay it. It's good, because it allows you to do stuff like that Krakow Jr. kill, where you dash spit the Waddle Doo at him and it leaves him with one or a very low amount of health, which you guard and it kills him. Guarding in enemies does some very low amount of damage in this game. Grab stone for Krakow, which will kill him in two stones. Do this optimally, it's pretty risky. That was pretty good. You can kill Krakow before he reaches the halfway point. Good standard. Then you got stone carried over to DDD. It's just one. So guarding does one damage, which is useful against Krakow Jr. And all it takes is three direct stones to kill DDD like that. If you're off by a little bit, the little dust clouds that come out of the stone will hurt, but do less damage. Now to my favorite part of the game, Milky Way Wishes. The whole gimmick of this game is you cannot get powers from random enemies. You have to find deluxe copies. It's kind of the collectible of Milky Way Wishes, and you need them all for 100%. And then you can choose your power at will. This allows for some really cool stuff, and in a marathon setting, it's pretty relaxing, because if you get your power knocked out, you're not screwed at all. And luckily, Sky High, First Planet, has the three best movement powers in the game. Jet, Wheel, and Wing. So that's very convenient. Sakurai knew. This is the only option for the planet to do first. You can do these in any order you want. It's a silly little door maze.
Downtown has a good setup for that. Right, left, right.
Oh yeah, don't even start with that. Just saw Krakow a few seconds ago. Ooh, never seen that happen. But now we gotta fight him again. So most bosses in this game you fight 2 to 3 times, but luckily this game is so good that you fight them with different powers, which makes for basically a different boss fight, as you can see here. Luckily they put the super candy right in the doorway. Hotbeat is a super tough planet. He's kinda gonna have to pray for good luck in a second. Save a bunch of time here. I guess you're intended to go up and get a super candy and come back. But right here, you just want to deboost through the lava.
Unfortunate. Oh, that's
the worst luck you can get. Yeah. So just, nobody knows how to make it consistent. You hit the lava, sometimes you go up.
Wow, he's getting over.
Yeah, these two rooms are crazy. But luckily, since the Milky Way Wishes, having your power knocked out doesn't matter beyond just a second or two. Wheelie also moves faster with Super Candy, and he also moves faster if you do a dash input. Even though it's hard to tell, he is definitely faster. Good. That's one of the first times a wheelie super jump can kind of mess you up. He decides to move. You'll see a lot more of those in Milky Way. Yeah, he despawned Wheelie back there because he's just going to lag the game and be useless up to the end. Tricky movement. The boss of this area is Camellia Arm again. This time you're using Jet. I think the patterns matter more in this fight. It's really tricky because you want to hit him with the burner, but he also has a fairly long invincibility period when you hit him with stuff. That was an amazing fight, by the way. That was just an amazing hot beat, other than the poor luck on the damage boost. The gameplay was all there. Trust me, that's a hard Camellia fight.
That guy, my personal favorite planet. This is really fun to play, I don't know, it's all Jet.
Yeah, it's super good. Rafi revolutionized it.
Yeah, with like one thing, but...
revolutionized, man. 2015 Mech-Eye. They're really generous with some super candies. Well, as you just run through that...
The level design in this game is really, 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 really good.
Yeah, it's so fun.
Here he hesitates for a second, so the elevator like descends.
Mm-hmm. Let's him just skip it instead of having to ride it. This is the Rafi tech.
Yeah, you can
Oh man.
Jet jump. The bottom. Which...
That saves more than you think. This is a super cool room. He's gonna play it risky, I'm sure. Two mini boss kills. Where you charge it into the room to make it fast. Yeah, looks so good. Swap to...
When you nail that, like, that whole room, it feels so nice.
Sure does. Yep, swap to wheel for an easy lobster kill. You see he took his hands off the controller because he parks his car up against the wall. Heavy lobster doesn't know how to dodge parked cars.
Yeah, if you slow down your wheel, you're invincible. Corner, it's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, okay, Cavios, this is the wheelie planet. Now, you remember I was saying wheelie can be kind of a jerk, moving out of the way? Well, he's gonna do 4 super jump kills off of wheelie. This one always goes correct, for some reason. But this planet's gonna look so sick if they all go correctly. Sick bomb grab. This is the tricky one. It's good stuff. Yeah, it's a very small area. You can plant the bomb on bonkers on the way down to instant kill him also. There's a crazy setup for this kill. Yep. All that weird movement just guaranteed that wheelie will stay there. And that was beautiful.
Another Iranus rat that set up.
Yeah, I don't know how he even discovered that.
Yeah.
So there's some weird stuff with Wheelie to kind of make him guarantee he doesn't jump around. This movement is so hard. The Super Candy Wheelie. This is the same Wham Bam fight as the first time, except it's a little less risky because you have some leftover invincibility for this first hit.
So close to the one cycle or whatever, two-hand kill.
Two-hand is the best you can do. Nothing wrong with three-hand, though. Head to the secret planet here, the question mark. Full attacks, which they grab you, take your power, or your partner. And they like to jump into pits with them afterwards. you let him run around too long, they can even like jetpack off the screen, which is pretty funny. First time it happens. You grab the copy power, which in a casual play could break Milky Way, because now you can use that to get powers off of random enemies. So here, this is Floria. I love Floria. He's probably going to go for what's known as Epic Floria. Help, partially discovered by Rafi. He came up with quite a few strats here. So far, it's pretty epic. Lots and lots of tight little movement things here. They add up. If you like yo-yo, the screen's for you. That's all you're gonna see of that. Weird thing with Wheelie. Oh, go ahead.
I was gonna say, this is Checker's favorite world.
Oh, yeah. Weird thing with Wheelie.
Play this. Oh, sorry.
I'll never get it out. No, it's fine. The weird thing with Wheelie is if you dash first before you start, before you, like, rev him up, then all the jumps you do will be a super high jump. It took forever to figure out, make it consistent, but that really helps out a lot on this planet. That was a pretty epic Floria. Just ram your car into some trees.
Oh. Hero says, explain the super wheelie jump. Basically, if you are going dash speed without hitting Y or hitting X, oh, no, hitting Y, you jump super high, really. About it. Yeah, you just get a super monster jump if you're dashing and jumping with a wheelie. Pretty cool. It's like one of the few things that. It's hard to tell from just watching speedrun.
I had to watch his hand cam to find it out. Anyway, we're on Oculus. This is the longest planet, I believe. Pretty cool, though. Well, the first half, anyway. Oh, this parasol. I wish there was a use for it, but there isn't.
Parasol is so... It's probably my favorite, ability, but unfortunately you don't even see it at all in fun.
So moving through water is pretty tough. You can conserve your momentum like he's doing by wheeling and then not pressing the D-pad in, I think, the direction you're going. Or it's something with not pressing the D-pad, but you can move up and down with it. But yeah, that was a pretty good section. That can go horribly wrong if you lose your momentum.
I wanted to despawn wheelie because laggy. And he can, like, pick up the... Maxim Tomato and like kiss you and stuff.
He can kiss you.
Yeah.
He can force himself on you. And you don't want it.
I thought he was going to D-boost again.
No.
I didn't want him to.
This is a sick kill. You can hurt him by stoning on Suplex's hand, and if you're far enough out, it won't hurt you when you get out, or when you unstone. And quick little death abuse to get back to the start of the room. Straight in the water.
Yeah, there's some RNG in that room. Down a little bit.
The first half of Oculus was super exciting. This is just a boring memory check to make sure you get through the maze. Then gonna fight Fatty Whale again. He's probably, depending on what pattern he gets, he might do something really cool. Save a few frames, but he's gonna park his wheel again, much like Heavy Lobster in the end. Okay, he's going for the frame savers. So this is the good pattern in the other two fights, but in this one it loses a bit of time. But he goes for those mid-air wheels like that because he's good at video games.
I don't know how hard that is to do. I don't want to know. It looks really hard.
I've never seen him mess it up, but I still don't want to do it. The wheel drains Fatty's life pretty fast. Yes, that was the fatter pattern, as Countdown would put it. So, Half Moon, super hard planet. Can't even see what's going on here. People have different methods for this, but basically you're just counting the amount of jets and hope you don't miss any to line that up perfectly. pretty tough minecart area here. Just grab the last two powers on this planet. Still is really hard though. There's a tough mini boss kill coming up. I'm kind of wondering what he might do for it.
Arf Moon.
Hopefully.
That'll be sick.
Maybe he should have a donation incentive to take this spike area without the star. Get some 1-ups.
I didn't even know you could do that.
Yeah, man, just skip the star. Fly through it. Oh, baby.
That's it.
That's Earth Moon.
I thought he messed it up.
That strat is so hard. You gotta do a really precise super jump jet, and you only have like 1 or 2 pixels to do that grab through the enemy. And it saves like a second. The baby strat is switched to plasma.
Nice, yeah. Though, because you end up with jet.
Yeah. This dude's crazy. Of course he stays inflated in the water.
Yeah, there's actually a cart-based difference, depending on which version of the game you have.
We're pretty sure.
Yeah.
Although countdowns supposedly works. Yeah. I don't know. We'll never know. Oh, and now, after all that amazing gameplay on Half Moon, he's getting owned by luck right here. Welcome to speedrunning. Luckily, you can switch to Hammer and get some cool kills on these guys. That toss is one of my favorites. See what the dragon does. Alright, pretty middle of the road luck. So far, hasn't been totally screwed by Battle Windows. And he's gonna practice some plasma for the upcoming boss fight. Let's look at that hand cam. That was a really good half moon. Oh man. So all that's left in Milky Way is gotta go to Nova, which is suddenly a shmup. Go through this area, then you gotta fight the Heart of Nova, which is a pretty interesting boss battle. He's like plasming in the Nova vehicle. What's this actually called? Like in the power window at the bottom? I don't actually know. I can't read Japanese. Yeah, basically, go through this part. Everything does a ton of damage. Probably die in 3 to 4 hits at best.
Oh, duh. This is Kirby.
Oh. Whoops.
I should have known that.
Oh, man.
It's kind of redundant. It says it right above it, too.
It says 3 times in the bottom bar. Anyway, this is the Heart of Nova. The strategy here is after you kill the 5th hole, I guess, it'll start going backwards. So what you want to do is, there's 7 total, so you kill 4, skip 2, okay, well there's 8 total, and then you skip the 5th and 6th, and you can kill the 7th and 8th like that, and then sets it up perfectly for this backwards. Running into them does massive damage, so you do have to be careful.
Good, overall.
Yeah.
World.
This Milky Way is just great, overall. And now you gotta fight Marks with plasma. So there's a quick kill on this guy. You gotta hit him with about 9 big ball shots. But the thing is, if you hit him with more than 5 in phase 1, he'll do a black hole attack. Alright, easy every time. And, now we watch the credits, because it's a tradition, about 3 minutes long, and I hear we hit 1K for the marathon, so let's hear about that.
Yeah, that's right. Dr. Harlem Jackson donated $20. Yo, JRTA, good luck with the marathon this year. And Garrison, our good pal Gary, donated $69.69. Hello, I'm cracking 1K, hopefully with this donation. Put me towards the Bags of Cash Arcplus. And he's referring to the Streamers run, which is a couple games away. Streamers also has an incentive for a Superb Joe run after the 16 Bags of Cash run. And since it's been a little while since I've said stuff, because the commentary has been excellent and I don't really want to interrupt you guys, this is JRTA2. We are raising money to get two Japanese runners to AGDQ 2016, Bacord and Ohan. Bacord will be running Gimmick, and he's on the waitlist for Wario Land 3 for AGDQ, and Ohan is going to be running Mega Man 6 and Castlevania 3, and he's on the waitlist for Mega Man 5. If you donate during this run, Kirby Superstar, you also entered in the chance to win two Super Famicom Kirby games donated generously by your Drizzle, Kirby Superstar, which you're watching right now, as well as Kirby Dream Land 3. And don't worry if you, you know, enter and you win and you have Super Nintendo but not a Super Famicom, because it's pretty easy to mod your SNES to be able to play Super Famicom games. And any donation of $10 will enter you in a chance to win the prizes. And while you're while you're donating, you can also donate towards incentives. The next couple things we've got going up is Blastdozer, which is I believe Blastcore in America, has got a file name, and right now Anime is winning, as it should be. And then a couple runs later, like I said, Streamers has a Joe, the Superb Joe run. And then there is a incentive to play and beat Trip World during the credits of Final Fantasy 3 a little bit later tonight or early Sunday or Saturday morning, depending on what your time zone is. So that's mostly what I got. Hopefully I didn't talk past the credits.
Good. That was just about the whole credits. Pretty good timing.
Thank you. I've been wanting to say stuff, but I've been just letting you guys talk because it's really good commentary. Oh, yeah.
This is exactly what happened at SGDQ, was just talking the whole run and then 3 minute storm during the credits of reading stuff. But yeah, so after you, I hope you all saw Honky's massive Kirby collection, because that was impressive. I think the man is Kirby, but now he's got to take on the arena, the ultimate challenge in the game. And of course he's going to grab Plasma, which means his hand cam is going to get interesting. Gotta fight all the bosses in the game again. Starting off with the toughest of all, Waddle Dee. These fights are actually all pretty interesting. You can see Waddle Dee, if you use a strong enough attack, he flies up in the air, so you gotta do a cool kill there. This is one of two mini-boss gauntlets. This is the heavy version. Bonkers has so much HP. Ooh. He actually shot a shot so fast that it went through him without... before he was vulnerable again. That's crazy fast. This reactor fight's the same as the first time. It's one of the only boss fights that isn't different at all. Which means it's still a pain in the ass. Pretty easy fight to choke at the end of your arena. Ooh. That was one of those tricky angles. Got through it. Emilio, you can see his slightly longer invincibility than most bosses. All three of his Camellia fights were incredible. Oh my god. Oh, this is one of my favorite fights.
Go ham.
Oh my god. What a fast double kill. But keep in mind, the back sparks from the fully charged plasma do the same damage as the ball itself. Yeah, DDD has a massive invincibility period.
Like Camellia, where you have to wait a little bit before shooting again.
Mm-hmm. This one's even bigger. Yeah, if you want a top time in this game, get your plasma to be this level. Have fun. Wimbim fight's pretty cool. Again, this is just one of the best parts of this speedrun, is even though you repeat bosses, there's completely different methods. And then you just have this awesome gauntlet at the end where you just, it's pure gameplay. Like you're an hour something into your run at this point. It's a pretty big rush.
Yeah, and it's super tiring. Like, I'm always all sweaty after.
Oh yeah. No shame if you're sweating after this. Nova's the same as well. It's a little risky though, because he actually no damaged it there, but it's pretty easy to take a hit. So if you're getting beat up by other bosses, it's usually safe to take a tomato before going into Nova. And Meta Knight is also the same, except you start on the right of the sword for whatever reason. See if you can do his revenge. Oh my gosh, Meta Knight's... That was better luck than last time, but he still did one of two invincible things. Really good fight though on Honky's part.
Gauntlet.
The other... Yep, Gauntlet 2. The lighter mini-bosses, there's four of them this time.
They have different enemies, but they're basically the same.
Duplex is still very scary though, because he does have an attack that always knocks your power out. Wispy is another boss with an extended invincibility period. Kind of awkward, but luckily you can overlap his hitbox with a plasma ball. So as soon as he's vulnerable, he'll take damage on the first frame. Again, hoping for a good pattern on Fatty. Okay, so he got the wrong pattern all three times, which is unfortunate. This isn't a massive loss or anything.
Try shooting him off screen.
Yeah. Plasma does hit off screen against certain bosses that can go off screen. To an extent.
Unfortunately, he got a bad pattern. He can just sit still. He can just sit there and like he can just go off. But
he can slow walk at you. Dynablade, I think, is the hardest fight in Arena to do properly.
Oh yeah, it's definitely up there.
So you're gonna see him try to get two shots per jump, I believe. Yeah, there you go. Little mistiming at first, but yeah.
Still really fast.
That is a lot of D-pad inputs, and it's really tricky. Ooh, almost got scary. Oh, this is... Okay, this is a good pattern. There you go, that was beautiful. Backspark set it up perfectly. Comes battle windows, pain in the ass fight, of course. You do have to play well for this, but you can also get decimated by luck. Ooh, that last shot was so fast, it didn't count. Comes the dragon. Okay, you gotta get in... Well, he's shooting all big balls, because he's really good at plasma. So it only took him 7 hits, that's really impressive. You can fit in about 4 attacks per phase. That was perfect luck, by the way, I believe. Unless, like, the knight did something slightly faster. This is the other hardest fight in Arena that he just nailed before I could explain it. So I'm not going to say anything else. You saw it. Here's Marks. Same as last time. Oh, the left shot. That's a classic. Yep, here's what happens. It's about an 8-second loss if you don't quick kill. Oh man. Oh man.
Oh my god.
Oh no!
That's unfortunate.
I don't even know what you use at this point. Oh my gosh.
He got greedy. He could have just swallowed the plasma.
Yeah.
And finished him off. But he was going... trying to be slightly faster, and now he's paying for it.
Yeah. That gives you cutter? What the? Luckily, this man is Kirby, and he will not lose.
Man, if he dies,
even to a black hole.
I will literally cry.
Oh, look at that finish. He planned it all along. No big deal. Time is coming up when this stops moving. So, about now.
Time. Yep. That was a really sick run, though, overall.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like, he lost, like, almost a minute just in Dino Blade compared to what he normally gets. Just due to the mixes and stuff like that. He'll beat my PB by...
Yo, 100%. What an amazing arena.
Yeah, other than the marks.
But yeah, first. Well, you know, he went for style. What's he doing? Oh, he's going for Samurai Kirby.
Finished run.
Oh, look at this hand technique.
Yeah, you gotta hold it like a sword. I don't think I've ever beat it on expert.
Oh, what was his time, by the way?
38. It would have been a 115 if it wasn't for the marks. We'll just give it to him.
Yeah, man. Why not?
Oh, he got wheeled.
Dang, he got flattened. What a way to go. What an image.
Dude, those sprites are...
Well, I guess that's it for Kirby Superstar.
Great job. Great.
That was
run.
Very nice.
Yeah, it was a really good run, and thank you guys for the commentary.
Yeah, of course.
Pleasure.
Hey, thanks for having me. I'm gonna head out now.
Yeah, thanks for being here. Have a good one.
Good luck with the rest.